UX professionals are surrounded by quantitative data. Analytics platforms, survey tools, and other systems can quickly entangle any design team with information overload and analysis paralysis. How can UX professionals prune all this data and pick out helpful insights? Consider using the Pareto Principle, or the 80-20 rule. It states that 80% of the results come from 20% of the causes. It's named after the 19th century Italian economist and engineer Vilfredo Pareto, who noticed that 80% of the peas from his garden came from just 20% of the pea pods. 20th century management consultant Joseph Duran rediscovered Pareto's work and popularized it as the Pareto Principle, to prioritize spending valuable effort on the vital few instead of the trivial many. Folks have discovered the Pareto Principle at work in a surprisingly wide range of situations, like 20% of websites capture 80% of web traffic, or 20% of customers generate 80% of the company's revenue, or even 20% of all possible openings are used in 80% of chess games. The Pareto Principle doesn't predict where or why this imbalance happens. Instead, think of it as a helpful observation that inputs and outputs aren't often evenly distributed. There may be many contributors, but only a few may meaningfully contribute to a given result. Here's a UX example. Let's say you're the designer for an app, and its customer satisfaction rating is sagging due to criticism about the app's quality. Folks are complaining it's unstable and buggy. Our goal is to improve customer satisfaction by improving the app. So we investigate the data in our bug tracking and support ticketing systems. When we link that data with our app's features, we discover that just 4 features are responsible for 80% of all bug and feedback submissions. That means if we invest effort in improving these 4 features, we should disproportionately improve customer satisfaction. So we then persuade our stakeholders to focus on these 4 features, even though there are other features with obvious or easier to implement fixes. But be careful. Excessive use of the Pareto Principle can lead to stagnation and over-optimizing a few metrics at the expense of others. Always reserve some bandwidth for studying other parts of your user experience, which may have a significant aggregated impact on different metrics or just provide helpful utility to users. UX teams generally have scarce resources, insufficient time, and a need to demonstrate business value to their organization. By leveraging the Pareto Principle's scaling effect, a UX team can cut through lots of data and achieve impactful results for less effort. And that's something to be happy about.